Back in the days, the early days of the Aurora Australis, we used to trawl them out of the ocean with a big trawl net. Nothing unusual about that. When moving krill around the ship, that was always done in buckets. So we would just put the krill into buckets and cart them off to wherever they had to go. The wet well was born out of making my first sea ice voyage in 2012. This is the voyage where we were stuck in sea ice that was up to 4 metres thick around the Aurora Australis for over 3 weeks, unable to move. And yet we know from having a hole in the ice and putting an ROV through the ice, a little submersible, we could see krill all around the ship. But could you put a net in to catch them? No, it's just too difficult. The wet well is effectively a way of getting a sample of water into a ship without using a pump, because the pump will damage the fragile marine life you're trying to collect. So what we've done is put the wet well below the waterline of the ship. It's down inside the engine room. Pipes connect the outside world, the underwater world, to the wet well. There are three of them, one at the keel, one just a metre below the surface, and one sort of midway between them. They're 125 millimetres in diameter, so it's about that sort of size. And when you open the hydraulic valve on them, the ship starts to sink. So water floods into that room. I was really excited about this voyage. Actually got a bit emotional there. So I just got to wind that back a bit. As we got down past 60 degrees, we started getting up earlier and earlier in the morning so we'd be there at the right time for krill to be at the surface of the night feeding. And on that occasion, we opened up the wet well at night, and almost instantaneously a live Antarctic krill appeared in front of us. Yeah, when that first krill came through, it was pretty much a grand final winning goal. It really was a lot of hooting and lots of fun. We then settled down and just did the methodical job of the scientist. The survivability of krill caught with the wet well, it turned out to be about 95%. And that's about an order of magnitude improvement over what we used to get with trawl nets and the old aquarium. So it really has revolutionised how we can work.
They've been doing really well. We've brought back probably 8,000 to 10,000 krill of differing ages. So lots of our juveniles and larvae have continued to develop, and they look really good. And not long after we returned, the handful of adults that we did catch actually spawned, and we're raising those eggs and larvae in captivity as well. I'm very glad not to have to carry buckets after buckets. Our pathway from the wet well up through the ship and out to the aquariums was seamless, all done through trolleys, and the ability to pump clean ocean water directly from the front of the ship and directly into containerised aquaria is an absolute game changer. I'm looking forward to having an intact back when I'm 50.
most of the big vertebrate predators, the seals, penguins, whales, and other seabirds, all rely on those big schools of krill being there in vast numbers at some time in their reproductive cycle if they're going to have a successful breeding season. So it's one species that is a linchpin to the success of the overall ecosystem. I mean, they're fundamentally beautiful animals. I mean, imagine having a set of blue iridescent lights bioluminescing down your front surface. I mean, they don't really need to dress up to go out.